G'day, my name's Brett Hooker and my channel is I Love Dirt. And I'm doing a video on the power box in my pod trailer. I've already done a video on the electrical fit out that I had custom off-grid solutions install on the pod, but I had a couple of questions from people asking about what was inside this power box. So I've taken the carpeted lid off the top of it. You can still see the carpet here on the sides. It normally has a carpeted lid with vents on the top, but I've taken that off so you can see the items that have been installed in here. First thing you'll notice is the quality of the install. You'll see that everything's beautifully cable tied and cable managed, etc. Why that's important is it makes it so much easier if you're trying to check things or if something needs to be replaced or checked, etc. You want to check your fuses, everything's neat and tidy. That's a really important part of outback touring. If you're going to go to remote places and you need to check things, you want to make sure that everything's installed really cleanly so it's easy to diagnose. And even in this install, you'll see that they've actually, you know, the major fuses on the battery here are labeled, you know, AC charger, DC charger, fuse box, they're all labeled. And right over here on the fuse box lid, hold that up to the camera. They've actually marked clearly on top of the fuse box lid what each of the fuses are. So I don't have to go chasing what things are. Everything's labeled really well. If you're enjoying the content we're producing on the I Love Dirt channel, go ahead and click the subscribe button and the like button to let other people know what we're doing and for you to stay up to date with the content we're producing. What's inside the box? That was the question. So the heart of it is this 200 amp hour Slimline Enerdrive lithium battery. I've found that 200 amp hours is absolutely the sweet spot for outback camping batteries. It'll power fridges for days, charge your phones and your other electrical devices, lighting, etc., etc. Just gives you so much power. You're really never chasing the sun with a lithium that size. If you're going 3 or 4 days without any sun, then obviously it's going to need to get hooked up for power. In this situation, we've actually got a solar input. And if we have a look just behind us on the ground there, you'll see we've just got a simple Redarc solar panel, just a nice folding one. It folds up nice and neatly and small, and that plugs into a solar Anderson input on the drawbar, and that easily keeps this battery topped up. So we've got the Enerdrive Slimline 200 amp hour lithium in there, but a couple other things in here. We've got the Enerdrive DC-DC charger. Now what this one's for is we've got a 240 volt inlet on the side here, so that runs through to that. So if I just want to top up the battery at home before I head out, there's a waterproof connector on the side here for 240 volts, so I don't have to open up the toolbox, just plug in the side. That'll take care of charging up the battery. But also the Anderson that comes through from the vehicle comes through to that device as well. So when you're driving, this is charging up the battery as well. But I've also got the Victron charger in here, and that's for solar input. These other items in the box, we've actually got cigarette sockets on the front of here and USBs on the front of here. So if I wanted to charge some devices, I can just pop them here in the toolbox, plug them in here, close the toolbox, even lock it if I wanted to, but I can actually charge and power things directly here in the toolbox. The other thing I had added, the top of this toolbox that's an option for the pod is actually angled down a little bit. And what I thought was, this is a perfect spot to pop a 40 amp solar panel. So this is a hard frame 40 amp solar panel. And what this does, if the trailer's just sitting, it's not hooked up to anything, it's not set up with a solar panel, etc., this 40 amp, which produces a couple of amps of power, actually keeps the battery inside there topped up anyway. So if you've just stopped somewhere, you've just got the trailer unplugged, you haven't set it up, but if there's sun on this, it's actually keeping the battery topped up at all times. So look, that's just a quick look. As I say, people wanted to see what was inside the battery box. That's what's inside there. Very clean install. Great job by Custom Off-Grid Solutions. And I'll see you again. Cheers.